And what Sukkot is telling us is Sukkot is when the Israelites went to the temple and celebrated the produce of the fields and they thanked HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but they never forgot when they came from. Because every time a nation forgets its youth, its childhood, the hard times they had when they were struggling to make it go, they become decadent and they eventually decline and fall. But Jews never are allowed to do that. Because it's enough that you're gerim and toshavim, that you're temporary residents and you're always asking me for another year of life. And it's enough. Don't think you've got a great big temple. I'm as good as the Egyptians and the Mesopotamians. I tell you, I'm good enough with a Mishkan. Because that is the Sukkah. That's the Schach. That memory of the Mishkan is good enough for me. The Mishkan was a temporary dwelling. But the odd thing is that the temple was a permanent dwelling and yet it was destroyed twice and we don't have it anymore. But the Mishkan, which could move anywhere because God is everywhere, became the symbol of the shul that you can build in Jerusalem, but also, not bad, in Hampstead Garden suburb. That became the permanent symbol. The temporary became permanent, and the permanent turned out only to be temporary. And the Sukkah is telling us something absolutely unbelievable, that you don't need to have mega bucks to buy a home for God. All you need is a garden shed and a bit of faith. And you have your schach, and they overshadow you the way the cherubs overshadowed the ark. And between the keruvim is the clouds of glory. The simplest, poorest Jew who turns his face to his brother or sister and builds a little sukkah is bathed in clouds of glory. And he has built his own private equivalent of the Mishkan. The basic moral is very profound. That even though the world sometimes seems very dark and full of danger, and even though we all worry, how is my health going to be? Is God going to write me in the book of life? How long do I have left? Sukkot says no. You can experience eternity in a moment. All you have to do is celebrate. Besimcha. And number two, you do not need a magnificent building to invite guests to. All you do is build a shed and you'll have the Ushbizin, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob themselves personally visiting you, trying to taste your honey cake. And one way or another, all you need to do is to love one another and turn our faces to one another and have enough faith in God. This temporary life and this temporary dwelling become filled with the clouds of glory. So may it be for all of us. May Hashem bathe us in the clouds of His glory and write us in the book of life. Ketiva v'chatima tova.